It's the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for Wednesday, the 30th of May. I'm Michael Groff. The weather turns breezy and slightly cooler here in the valley today, but we start a warming trend this weekend that continues into much of next week. Temperatures go way above average, and now we've hit 80 straight days without measurable rain here in Phoenix. How long will that continue? Well, a little hint for you, we're in the middle of the dry season, so likely for quite a while. First, we'll take a look at the almanac from yesterday. 102 degrees, the high in the valley after a morning low of 75. The normals, 99 and 73, so slightly above those. And outside right now, here just before 5 a.m., plenty of high clouds in the valley. And those helped hold temperatures up overnight. Look at this. We start this day out at 82 degrees at Sky Harbor. Dew points at 35, humidity 19%. The winds are calm and the barometer is rising. Temperatures around south central Arizona this morning, it's very warm out there. 73, the cool spot over toward Buckeye. Most of us here in Metro Phoenix, upper 70s and low 80s right now. The upper air look across the nation. We do have a trough that's going to be passing mainly north of Arizona over the next couple of days, and a subtropical ridge to our south that will be building in after this system departs. That'll be responsible for our warming trend. Taking a look at the watch warning map, flash flood watches and flood advisories still continue in parts of the southeast and up toward the Ohio Valley in association with what is left of the remnant circulation of Alberto. Out here in the west, nothing tropical at all, just dry. Red flag warnings extend from West Texas through northern Arizona. You know by now, the combination of low humidity and breezy to locally windy conditions, elevated fire danger here. Convective outlook for today, we've got the slight risk of severe storms from around Idaho Falls up toward Bozeman, Montana. Another little slight risk area around Enid, Oklahoma, and a marginal risk for many of the adjacent states there. And rainfall around here for the next 7 days. How about nothing? Statewide, maybe skirting the eastern border of our state, but really wouldn't expect anything around here anytime soon. Again, not for probably another 4 or 5 weeks until the monsoon starts to get cranked up. Let's talk about the details of our weather now as we get out to the models and have a look at it. This is the GFS, the 06Z run, valid at 5 o'clock this afternoon. And this is our upper chart at about 18,000 feet in the atmosphere. We've got a trough here lined up along the west coast. And that's going to start to progress east today and tomorrow down at the surface. That just translates to a few high clouds, but otherwise mostly sunny. High temperatures today climb into the mid and upper 90s. I think we'll stay just shy of the century mark. Might touch 100 degrees in the warmest spots, but a little bit cooler than yesterday. Some southwest westerly breezes, 8 to 20 miles per hour. Stronger gusts over Southern California. Might even see some patching blowing dust out that way. Tonight with mostly clear to partly cloudy skies, lows mainly in the 60s to mid 70s, and then tomorrow, again, other than a few high clouds, we'll be mostly sunny and high temperatures, upper 90s to about 100. All right, 100 to 103 on Friday, mostly sunny. The subtropical ridge will start to build back toward the north across northern Mexico, west Texas. Saturday, highs 102 to 105, 103 to 106 on Sunday. Could be as high as 108 on Monday with mostly sunny skies and maybe some afternoon breezes, as is typical for this time of year. Tuesday, more of the same, more or less. Strong ridging over the southern plain states. High temperatures might drop back a degree or two, but still highs will be somewhere between 103 and 106. Here's a week from today. This is Wednesday, the 6th of June. Still got the 591 ridge over the southern plain states. This isn't quite as strong as some of the previous runs, but the ridge will still be the dominant weather feature for us with the 588 decameter contour right over top of Phoenix. So that means high temperatures, still 103 to 106. Here's Thursday, the 7th of June. We're still hot and dry. And the end of the 10-day forecast period, Friday, the 8th of June. Troughing passes well north of Arizona, and that may prevent temperatures, at least for the latter part of next week, from getting completely out of hand. But we'll still be above average. I would expect high temperatures somewhere between 105 and 108. Look at that 594 contour getting into southern Wisconsin. So it's going to be toasty for the Central Plains next week. Wow. Okay, taking a look at the temperatures through the period coming off of the GFS ensemble. Almost all of these numbers are above average for this time of year. Now, not ridiculously out of bounds for early to mid-June, although I do see some 110s and 111s popping up there out toward about 11 and 12 days out. So if that verifies, still below record criteria, but really, really toasty. All right. That's going to do it for the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for today. My next video back here tomorrow morning. If you enjoy our videos, be sure to subscribe so that whenever we post a brand new one, you'll get the notifications. Otherwise, be safe and stay cool out there. Stay hydrated. Drink lots of water. And you guys have yourselves a great Wednesday.